Good day, everyone.
Good day, everyone.
Today we gather to celebrate and honor Saint Damien of Molokai, the famous missionary who went to serve the people of Hawaii, in particular those who were suffering from leprosy and were quarantined on their own island. So we ask for Saint Damien's intercession in a particular way for all those who are suffering from the coronavirus and for those of our healthcare caregivers who are taking care of our sick. Our Mass today is offered for William and Grace Boudreau, and I also ask you to pray for my cousin Sophia Munish, who died this morning in New Bedford after a long illness. So we keep her family in our prayers. And so we begin by singing the prayer of Saint Francis.
Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon hold. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never see so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
My brothers and sisters, to prepare our hearts and minds to celebrate worthily these sacred mysteries, we turn to our Heavenly Father and ask for His mercy. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Father of mercy, who gave us in Saint Damien of Molokai a shining witness of love for the poorest and most abandoned, grant that by his intercession, as faithful witnesses of the heart of your Son Jesus, we too may be servants of the most needy and rejected. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
shouted when they heard this and glorified the word of the Lord. All who were destined for eternal life came to believe, and the word of the Lord continued to spread throughout the whole region. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm, here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
I have waited for the Lord, and he stooped toward me and heard my cry. And he put a new song into my mouth, a hymn to our God.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Sacrifice or offering you wish not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Burnt offerings or sin offerings you sought not. Then said I, behold, I come.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
In the written scroll it is prescribed for me, to do your will, O my God, is my delight, and your law is within my heart.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips, as you, O Lord, know.
Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
Feast
of Saint Damien of Molokai, or Father Damien as he is belovedly known, is usually celebrated on May 10th every year, but this year, because it falls on a Sunday, the fifth Sunday of Easter takes precedence. So during this week, we're celebrating and honoring him a little earlier. Father Damien had left his home of Belgium and was sent as part of his religious congregation, the Sacred Hearts of Jesus and Mary. He was sent on a mission to go to Hawaii in the late 19th century, which was still an independent nation and kingdom. And Father Damien was sent to work with a colony of lepers, those who had literally been quarantined apart from family and friends, living on their own island with very little. And Father Damien, through his own witness, through his own example, through his own perseverance, would help build a small community there. All the necessities that would be needed to help not only the lepers physically, but to also help them emotionally, so they knew that they were connected to a community. And Father Damien worked for many years ministering to the lepers, and finally he himself would succumb to that disease. He is the patron of those who may have leprosy or other ailments that have ostracized people from society. Many of those who are living with HIV and AIDS have taken Father Damien as their own patron because of his not fear of helping those who were sick. When I was preparing for our celebration today in honor of Father Damien, I found this quote, which in many ways is twofold striking. First about the Eucharist, but then about our own quiet, individual prayers. So let's listen to the words of Father Damien. Jesus Christ treats missionaries in a very special manner, for it is he who guides their footsteps and preserves them from all danger. I find my consolation in the one and only companion who will never leave me. That is our divine Savior in the Holy Eucharist. It is at the foot of the altar that we find strength necessary in this isolation of ours. Without the Blessed Sacrament, a position like mine would be unbearable. But having our Lord at my side, I continue always to be happy and content. Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament is the most tender of friends with souls who seek to please him. His goodness knows how to proportion itself to the smallest of his creatures as to the greatest of them. Be not afraid, then, in your solitary conversations, to tell him of your miseries, your fears, your worries, of those who are dear to you, of your projects and of your hopes. Do so with confidence and with an open heart. Let's listen again to that last line. Be not afraid then, in your solitary conversations, in your time being at home during this time of the COVID pandemic. Be not afraid that in this time of pandemic to tell the Lord of your miseries, your fears, your worries, of those who are dear to you, of your projects and of your hopes. Do so with confidence and with an open heart. Yes, as Father Damien writes to us, he reminds us that at the foot of the altar, yes, when we are able to receive the gift of the Holy Eucharist, we are strengthened. We know that the Lord is present with us in a real physical way as we receive his body and blood. But my brothers and sisters, As Father Damien also reminds us, in our own conversations with the Lord, in our own moments of prayer, especially when we're able to find a quiet time during our day, especially for our families, where the kids may be in one corner doing schoolwork, mom and dad doing their office work, working remotely. Sometimes it's hard to find that quiet moment, but when we can find that quiet moment with the Lord, to have a conversation, to not be afraid, to just pour out our hearts. Maybe in these quiet conversations, maybe begin with Scripture, the Word of God. Remember, Jesus said, not by bread does man alone live, but by the every word that comes from the mouth of God. So that Jesus feeds us in those quiet moments of prayer, when we may read Scripture, when we may read about the life of the saint. Maybe you want to Google more about Father Damien. I know how hard it is, how hungry many of us are to receive the gift of the Eucharist. But never forget that Jesus satisfies the hungry heart, not just with his precious body, but by his word, by those special devotions and prayers that we pray, especially now with our whole hearts and minds focused. Do not be afraid then, in your solitary conversations, to tell the Lord Jesus of your miseries, of your fears, your worries for loved ones who may be suffering from the coronavirus, your worry for loved ones who may be facing unemployment or layoffs. Of those who are dear to you, how many of our grandparents are unable to hug their precious grandchildren, or even the grandchildren being able to go and touch and be with their grandparents, and how hard it might be this weekend with Mother's Day, when all we may be able to do is drive by, wave from the car window, stay out on the porches and through glass, say hi to our moms and godmothers or grandmothers or all those special women in our lives. Bring to the Lord then those who are dear to you, of your projects and of your hopes. Do so with confidence and with an open heart. Father Damien, we ask for your intercession as we pray in our day and age for those who are suffering from the coronavirus, who themselves may be quarantined, isolated, separated from others so that they may be protected. Pray for those. And Father Damien, in your loving hands, watch over our incredible nurses and doctors and healthcare professionals who are caring for the sick with great love and compassion. Father Damien, pray for us. As so many of us face much anxiety in this pandemic, let us raise our minds and hearts in prayer to God, the giver and lover of all life. We pray for our leaders in healthcare and governance, that in this time of great danger for all of us, they may make the right decisions for the well-being of all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all people who are suffering from the coronavirus, and particularly for those in intensive care and in our nursing homes. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We continue to pray for all of our family and friends who have lost a loved one during this past week and are unable to be comforted by the physical embraces of friends. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, our family members, friends, benefactors, and especially William and Grace Boudreau, for whom our Mass is offered. May they come to the banquet of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the Catholic community of Gloucester and Rockport. May the Holy Spirit unite us as a community in prayer, fellowship, and service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we bow our heads and remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions that have been entrusted to us and placed in our prayer basket before this altar. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, may your love and compassion be constantly with us in our lives, through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look upon the sacrificial gifts we offer, Almighty God, on this day in which we honor Saint Damien of Molokai, and grant that we who celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion may imitate what we now do through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the rising the life of all has arisen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the
they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it,
For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith. Together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, the clergy, the religious, and all of your people. Remember your servants, William and Grace Boudreau, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also Sophia Munij and also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and Our Lady of Good Voyage, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Anne and Saint Joachim, Saint Damien of Molokai, Saint Francis and Saint Clare, Saint Anthony and Saint Mary Magdalene, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you,
My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Remain in me as I remain in you, says the Lord. Whoever remains in me and I in him bears fruit in plenty. Alleluia. Let us pray. By the power of this mystery, O Lord, confirm your servants in the true faith, that they may everywhere profess in word and deed the faith for which blessed Damien of Molokai never ceased to labor and for which he spent his whole life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And please join now in singing our Easter hymn to Mary, Regina Caeli.